Good morning, dreamers. How are you today? What a day. Back to work yesterday. Got home. Christmas is all put away. House is tidy. It was great. It was great. I woke up and went, oh, I can breathe. It's wonderful to be able to breathe, right? Absolutely wonderful. And back to school. No, anyway, that's a different topic. Back to work again today. And today's got some big projects in it. And yeah, could be a long one. But if things tick along well, then it's going to be, regardless, it's going to be a good day. I just finished reading Bob's book again. It's just beautiful. Today's topic of living in anticipation. You see, last year I had a huge fight with hope. I didn't want hope. I didn't want it at all. And I thought if I could just learn to live without hope, I'd be okay. Then I wouldn't have disappointments and I wouldn't have failings and I wouldn't have, you know, if I'm not expecting anything, then nothing can disappoint me. Isn't that awful? But that's where I was last year. And God walked with me using a lot of things, and Bob's book being one of them. No, he's not a sponsor. Never met the man, but I've met him in his writing, and I connect with him in his writing. And I remembered the story from this time last year of thousands and thousands of fireworks going off at the same time. And the whole concept is the people press the button too soon, or they press the buttons at the same time, but they press the buttons and it was worth it. And sometimes there's this thing sitting in front of us that we want to engage in and we want to take apart, make a part of our life, but we're afraid. And so we don't press the button, we don't press the button, we don't press the button. And whatever it is, whether it's starting a health and wellness plan to become physically fit, whether it's I'm going to run a marathon this year, that's not me talking, by the way, I'm just saying that could be whatever it is. It's now the 4th of January. So anyone who did make a resolution has probably fallen short of it already. But his point is that if we just get at it, maybe you need to write a book. That is me talking. I don't know what it is that you have to do and what God has for you. But press the button. Get started. Will it be an epic failure? Maybe, but it'll be legendary and thousands of fireworks will go off at the same time and it will be the most beautiful thing you've ever seen. Why? Because you tried, because you made an effort and you did it. And I know there are people in my life that keep pushing buttons, they keep going, and every time they hit a wall and it's like, well, then that wasn't it. Well, let's try the next thing. Keep going. And it wasn't it. And it gets very discouraging, and it can be quite overwhelming to have unmet hope and unmet expectations. But the whole thing is, you must try. You must keep pressing the buttons, because God's going to make something spectacular. And even if in the eyes of humankind it is a failure because everything goes off at once instead of a 1-hour fireworks show, God says, that's my beauty. I've made something beautiful out of that. That person stepped out in faith and pressed the buttons on their fireworks, and I made their fireworks a beautiful thing. Anyway, I'm at the 4-minute mark, so I gotta go now. I'm just hoping you're picking up what I'm saying. Press the button. Get doing something. It's going to be beautiful. Don't be afraid to initiate whatever your plan might be. Sweet dreams. Bye.